Hi there everybody, hope you're all keeping well. My name's David Inman and today's Bitesize APC Mandatory Competency webinar is about accounting principles and procedures. Now before we start, I am not an accountant, I am a chartered surveyor. But I think this is a fantastic competency, not just for the APC, but for business life in general. It's vital in business that we all know about company finances, whether you run a company such as myself or you work for a company. It's really important. And in terms of this competency, with your APC, you get involved in lots of business functions. And I have seen candidates over the years get unstuck and get into trouble answering questions about accounting theory. And they've not been able to answer basic questions. So this webinar, we're going to look at the basics of accounting and help you with your APC. I'd just like to say thanks to everybody who watches our channel, and if you like our videos, please subscribe, please tell your friends and colleagues about us, we really do appreciate it. So level one, as always, is about understanding the topic, and it's about accounting concepts, format and preparation of management and company accounts, and this includes profit and loss statements, cash flow statements and balance sheets. Now, if you're employed by a company, try and get a copy of the final accounts and ask your employer how are they prepared. This will be really useful for you with this competency. In the public sector, if you work there, ask how the organisation you work for prepares their accounts and what are the legal requirements within your employer's world. Please, for this competency, don't submit that you do your expenses. Great, you do your expenses, but that's not accounting. So avoid that, but make sure you understand the accounting processes of the organisation that you work for. For this webinar, we're going to focus on the UK, because that's where I practice and that's where I live. But candidates outside of the UK watching this, please do the same in your country of practice. So in the UK, a company must deliver accounts every year to company's house, even if the company is dormant. Non-compliance with this might lead to the UK government assuming that the company is no longer carrying on business or in operation, and the government can take steps to strike it from the register. If the company is struck off the register, it ceases to exist, and its assets become Crown property. In the UK, you must keep accounting records as a business. And these accounting records must contain records showing all money received and spent by the company, and a record of the assets and liabilities, which is basically what you have in terms of capital and money, and what you are, so assets and liabilities. If the company deals in goods, the records must contain statements of stock held by the company at the end of each financial year. All statements of stock takings this statement is based on must also be in the records. And it must also keep statements of all goods sold and purchased, except goods sold to the members of the public by retail sellers. But these statements of all goods must contain listings of goods, the buyers and the sellers. Private companies must keep accounting records for 3 years from the date they were made, and public companies must keep them for 6 years. Records can be kept in digital or paper format. The actual accounts in the UK must include the profits and loss account, a balance sheet signed by a director on behalf of the board, notes to the accounts, and any accounts, if applicable, to a wider corporate group that the company controls. accounts must generally be accompanied by a director's report, signed by a company secretary or a director, a business review if the company does not qualify as a small business, and we're going to be looking at this a little bit later on, and an auditor's report stating the name of the auditor and signed and dated by them, unless the company is exempt from audit. We're going to look at exemptions from audit a little bit later also. In the UK, there is no requirement for companies to use a professional accountant. You can do them yourselves. However, professional advice will help meet legal requirements. There are 6 chartered accountancy professional bodies in the UK and Ireland. My accountant is a member of the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales, who are the regulating body, as is RICS, the regulating body of chartered surveyors. Behind accounting theory, there are standards. And at the top level, there's the International Financial Reporting Standard, or IFRS. These set common rules so that finance statements through the world can be consistent, transparent, and comparable across the world. And IFRS are issued by the International Accounting Standards Board. In the UK, accountants use generally accepted accounting practice, which is called UK GAAP. And this body of accounting standards is published by the UK's Financial Reporting Council. We're now going to look at some accounting terminology, starting with profit and loss statement. The profit and loss, or P&L statement, is a financial statement that summarises the revenues, costs and expenses incurred during a specified period, usually a fiscal quarter of the year. Gross profit is the profit a company makes after deducting the costs associated with making and selling its products or the costs associated with providing its services. So gross profit equals the revenue minus the costs. Net profit, also called net earnings, is the net income and informally known as the bottom line. And it's calculated by adding up a business's total expenses and subtracting that from its revenue. So total revenue minus all the expenses equals net profit. We've already talked about financial auditing, and this is when auditors come in behind accountants and verify their work. They examine the financial statements prepared by accountants and ensure that they represent the company's financial position accurately. In the UK, small and micro-sized businesses are exempt from auditing, and to qualify, they must meet any 2 of the following. Their annual turnover must not be more than £10.2 million a year. The balance sheet total must not be more than £5.1 million. And the average number of employees must not be more than 50. So level 1 of this competency looks at your knowledge and understanding of accounting concepts, which we've had a look at today. Level 2 of this competency is to interpret accounts and balance statements and apply appropriate accounting and legal standards. And level 3 is providing reasoned advice, including the carrying out of accounting activities. So levels 2 and 3 are pretty specialised. So don't think that you understand accounts and you maybe prepare some financial statements as part of your job means you can do level 2 and level 3. Take heed, they are very specialist. And as always, we really hope you found the video useful. If you've liked it and you haven't done so before, please subscribe. please tell your friends and colleagues about our channel, and good luck with your APC.